special request, focus more because this is an important topic and a bit dry topic, so you have to focus more. Though it's a very small unit. Coming to unit 4, it has 8086 pin configuration, signal discussion, various types of registers discussion like general purpose registers, segment registers, what is pipelining, what are flag registers, what are the addressing modes of 8086 and so on. Okay, so we had just said that 8086 processor is from Intel, is it not? It is an Intel family of processors. Okay, I have to take the help of the book. Give me a minute. And this is the book we are referring for this unit 4, Advanced Microprocessors and Peripherals by A.K. Ray. You can use Douglas Hall also. So these two books are recommended. So I am referring this book. The PDF is also available in the Google Classroom. So we are speaking about various types of processors, how the processors evolved, right from 4004 to 8008, then 8085, then 8086. So 8086 was released by Intel in the year 1978. So naturally, as it came later to a 4004 and 8008 and 8085, so it has higher capabilities, be it processing capabilities, be it addressing capabilities, be it special features like different modes, addressing capabilities, all that are better. So, but we, though 8086 is there in our syllabus, we know that the journey did not end there for Intel family. It went from 8086 to 186 to 286, 386, 486, 586, Pentium. Then now you use all those i3s and i5s and i7s CPUs. Is it not? Let me just go to the first chapter. Let us focus on this registers. So if you had seen the syllabus spoke about the various kinds of registers such as general purpose registers, segment registers. So let us look here this diagram. So this diagram speaks about various kinds of registers of 8086. Various kinds of registers of 8086. So just take few seconds to go through this. First look at the general data registers or general purpose registers. Then look at segment registers. Look at pointer and index registers. And this is the flag or program stated word register. Take a few seconds to absorb that. Okay, so we are discussing 8086. 8086 is a CPU. 8086 is a processor. 8086 is a microprocessor. 8086 is a microprocessor which is backward compatible with 8085, which is backward compatible with 8085. There are differences naturally, like addressing capabilities may be different, but interfacing, as far as memory interfacing is concerned, it is similar to 8085. 8086 is a 16-bit microprocessor. 8086 is a 16-bit microprocessor, but as it is backward compatible, it is it may be similar to 8-bit microprocessor also. It may be similar to 8-bit microprocessor also. Okay. So in 8086, there are different types of registers. In 8086, there are different types of registers. And this diagram highlights those types of registers. First types of register is general registers. Second type of register is segment registers. Third type of registers is pointer and index registers. Third type of registers is pointer and index registers. Let us look at the general registers. Let us look at the general registers. Which are the general registers? The general registers are AX, BX, CX, and DX. As the name itself is general register, these registers are general purpose registers. These registers are general purpose registers. What is the size? What is our 8086? 8086 is a 16-bit microprocessor. 8086 is a 16-bit microprocessor. So these registers AX, BX, CX, and DX, these are 16-bit registers. These are 16-bit registers. Now, these 16-bit registers, you can see, are divided into two halves, the low order and the high order, the lower bytes and the higher bytes. So the lower byte ones will be called as AL, BL, CL, DL. And the higher bytes will be called as the AH, BH, CH, DH, AH, BH, CH, DH. Okay. Now, in this, for example, if you take this AL, this is called as the actually AX. This AX is called as the accumulator register. This AX is called as the accumulator register. Okay. So this AX size is 16, but if you take AL, this is the lower byte. This is the lower byte of the accumulator register, and its size is 8 bits. And its size is 8 bits. So it will be used for 8-bit operations. It will be used for 8-bit operations. Now, this is separation HL, HL, HL is there. Na? This is for higher bytes, and this is for lower bytes. So higher bytes of accumulator register, lower bytes of BX register, higher bytes of DX register, lower bytes of CX register, like that. Okay. So just this letter L and letter H indicate lower byte and the higher byte. Lower byte and the higher byte. Okay. If you look at this CX, this CX register is used as a counter register. This CX register is used as a counter register. So I'll just put the same thing in the chat window just to emphasize what is the purpose. For example, AX, I'm typing in the chat window, AX is accumulator. Similarly, if you take CX register, CX acts as a counter. CX acts as a counter whenever we'll be performing string and loop operations. CX acts as a counter whenever we perform string and loop operations. If you look at DX, okay, DX is a general purpose register. DX is a general purpose register. Now, as DX is a general purpose register, okay, it acts as an operand, either as an operand or as a destination. It acts as an operand or as a destination in case of few instructions. Now, what about this BX register? This BX register is used as an offset storage register. This BX register is used as an offset storage register. As an offset storage register. As you can see here, I'm just mentioning this from here. So now we know what are general purpose registers, not elaborately, but at least we know their names, and we know their purposes and so on. So similarly, let us look at the next category of registers, which are the segment registers, Okay, so how many segment registers we are seeing? Four segment registers we are seeing. What are the names of these four segment registers? CS, SS, DS, and ES. What is the long form of all of them? CS stands for code segment. SS stands for stack segment. DS stands for data segment. ES stands for extra segment. So basically, these are the segment registers. What is the use of these segment registers? The memory of 8086. The memory of 8086 is segmented memory. The memory of 8086 is segmented memory. Means what? Okay, so 8086 has 1 megabyte of memory. 8086 has 1 megabyte of memory. So this 1 megabyte of memory, with the help of addresses, is divided into 16 logical segments. So naturally, what will be the size of each segment? What are the capabilities of each segment? That will be 64 kilobytes of memory. Hopefully, you are with me. Hopefully, you are listening to me. As the topic needs more focus, I have a special request to concentrate more today. Which point we are discussing? We are discussing segment registers. What is segment registers? When you say what is segment registers, you should say that there is code segment, stack segment, data segment, and extra segment. These are the four segment registers. But why segment registers? You should say that the memory of 8086, is segmented memory. What is the meaning of this? The meaning of this is 8086, the size of 8086 memory is 1 megabyte. Thus, this 1 megabyte is divided into 16 logical segments. Each segment contains 64 kilobytes of memory. But there are four segment registers. There is a difference here. We are speaking about there are four segment registers called as code segment, stack segment, data segment, and extra segment. But there are 16 logical segments. Let us look at the first segment, which is called as the code segment. Code segment contains the word what? Code. It means the executable code. The executable code or the executable program or your program is stored in the code segment. Okay. So the code segment register will be pointing. Pointing means the addressing of the particular program, particular code will be done with the help of code segment register. Now coming to the next. What is the next one? Let us take the stack segment. Okay, what is the purpose of a stack segment? The purpose of a stack segment is it will be pointing or it will be identifying the stack segment addresses. Now, what is a stack segment? It will be storing the stack data. Similarly, the data segment register will be pointing to the data segment which consists of the data. The extra segment register will be identifying the addresses, connecting the addresses of the extra segment. The extra segment also consists of data. The extra segment also consists of data. Now, hopefully you are understanding what I'm trying to say. I'll try to make it more layman-like, more simpler. Let us treat your memory as a space. What is the size of this memory? 1 megabyte. So this big space of one megabyte consists of what? The memory consists of data, the memory consists of files, the memory consists of programs, everything will be there in the memory. Now, as we are discussing the architecture of 8086, the registers of 8086, we are understanding that there is an effort to segregate or to separate the contents of the memory. Like in some part code will be there, in some part data will be there, in some part stack related content will be there. So like that. So that is done with the help of what? That is done with the help of segments. How you can understand what is a segment? Segment is, let us say, a small chunk of a big memory. Let us say there is a big pizza. So that pizza is your complete memory. Now, four friends are eating that pizza. So four pieces you are making. So you are creating four segments actually. So here, how many segments 8086 is creating? 16 logical segments 8086 is creating. So the memory has 16 parts, 16 pizza pieces, you can say. In those pieces, the data, the code, the program, the stack data, everything will be there. But what is the purpose of these registers then? Code segment register, stack segment register, data segment register, extra segment register. All these registers will be used for addressing. Suppose you require some data. That data is in data segment at a particular memory location. It is at which memory location that will be helped with the help of the data segment register. Similarly, you have written a program. You want to execute that program. That program is in code segment, in a memory part of code segment. But it may be at a particular memory location. So going to that particular memory location, you need address of that particular memory location. So identifying the address of that particular memory location will be done with the help of this code segment register. Now, coming to the addressing part, let us not forget what is this simple concept. The simple concept is memory is there. In the memory, your data and programs and many other things are there. So basically your data and programs are there. So these data and programs are resided at a particular address, at different addresses. Let us say Nikita writes one program and her program is residing in some address at, let us say, 10,000 memory location. Let us say Uday Teja has written a program and he has executed the program. The output of that program maybe is at some address, maybe 20,000 memory location. So that is what we are trying to convey. The address. Now, the actual address is called as the physical address. Listen very, very, very carefully what I am saying. The actual address is called as the physical address. Of what? Of whatever you want. For example, you want data. For example, you want program. This physical address is calculated with the help of two things. With the help of segment address and with the help of offset address. So I'll just again mention in the chat window just to emphasize that physical address. So if you want to find out the physical address, for that you require segment address as well as you require the offset address. So just look at the chat window also. So what I'm trying to convey is, if you want a physical address, that physical address you can get with the help of segment address and the offset address. Okay, now what is the size of the segment registers, or what is the size of this general purpose register? You know that they are all 16-bit registers. But what is the actual memory size? The actual memory size is 1 megabyte. As the actual memory size is 1 megabyte, how many bits we require for addressing? We require 20 bits for addressing. I may be going a bit faster, but remember that. What is that? We are speaking about 8086. And how much memory is of 8086? 8086 has 1 megabyte. 8086 has 1 megabyte. So how many bits we require for addressing? We require 20 bits for addressing. So we are speaking about the physical address. We are speaking about the physical address. But how the physical address is calculated? The physical address is calculated with the help of segment address and the offset address. The physical address is calculated with the help of segment address and the offset address. Okay. From where you'll be getting the segment address, this segment registers will be facilitating that. Which are the segment registers? Core segment, stack segment, data segment, and extra segment. What is the size of those registers? The size of those registers is 16 bit. The size of those registers is 16 bit. Now, what about the offset address? The offset address will be given. The offset address will be given by the pointer registers. The offset address will be given by the pointer registers, as well as index registers, as well as the BX registers. So, offset address, remember, the offset address is given by the pointer register. The offset address is given by the index register. The offset address is given by the BX registers. Why we require offset register? Because we want to calculate the physical address. Because we want to calculate the physical address. How to calculate the physical address? To calculate the physical address, we need to know the segment address and we need to know the offset address. Who will be giving the segment address? The segment registers will be giving the segment address. Who will be giving the offset address? The pointer registers, the index registers, and the BX register will be giving the offset register. What is the size of the physical address? The size of the physical address is 20 bits. What is the size of the segment address? It is 16 bit. What is the size of the pointer register or the index registers or BX register? It is 16 bit. So just remember this. Just remember this. Now, we are basically discussing various registers of 8086. First, we have done this. General purpose registers AX, BX, CX, DX, which are having AH, AL, BH, BL, CH, CL, DI, DL. Then we discuss the segment registers called as core segment, stack segment, data segment, and extra segment. We also have pointer and index registers, which we referred just now. Which are the pointer and index registers? SP, BP, SI, DI, and IP. Okay. So these are the pointer and index registers. Okay. So SP stands for stack pointer, BP stands for base pointer, SI stands for source index, DI stands for destination index, IP stands for instruction pointer. You know the purpose of instruction pointer, which contains the address of the next instruction to be executed, Okay. So what is the purpose of the pointer registers? See, these are the two pointer registers. Which are the two pointer registers? SP and BP. These are the two pointer registers. What the pointer register contains? The pointer register contains the offset. The pointer register contains the offset means what? They contain the displacement. So just remember, maybe you're not understanding for the first time, but remember the keywords which I'm speaking. What I'm speaking about? I'm speaking about pointer registers. Which are the two pointer registers visible here? Stack pointer and base pointer. What is the purpose of the pointer register? The pointer registers will be containing the offset. What is the meaning of offset? The meaning of offset is displacement. Okay. So next one are the index registers. Which are the two index registers which we are finding out? The source index and the destination index. Okay. They also will be storing the offset addresses. Provided the addressing mode is index or the base index or the relative base index. we know the addressing modes, right? Index addressing mode, base index addressing mode, relative index addressing mode. In such case, they will be providing the offsets. In such case, they will be providing the offset. Now, SI, this SI stands for source index. So it will be containing the offset of the source data. DI is destination index. It contains the offset of the destination data. It contains the offset of the destination data. Okay. Now, basically, these two index registers, SI and DI, these two index registers, SI and DI, are used for string manipulation. Are used for string manipulation. So this discussion helped us in understanding the register organization of 8086, which comprises of general registers, segment registers, pointer and index registers. General registers are AX, BX, CX, DX. Segment registers are code segment, stack segment, data segment, extra segment. Pointer and index registers are stack pointer, base pointer, source index, destination index, and instruction pointer. So, as there were discussion of address calculation, we had said that there is something called as a segment address. There is something called as an offset address. Offset address is given by whom? Offset address is given by this pointer and the index registers. Offset address is given by the pointer and index registers. Okay. Then, what about this segment address? This segment address is given by these segment registers, which are the segment registers, code segment, stack segment, data segment, and extra segment. Now, what basically is this addressing? Why we want address? Because let us say you want to execute your program. So that program is in memory. So that program is in memory means it has some address. So that program may contain many instructions. So those instructions may also have addresses. Many data, those data may also have addresses. So you need to know their addresses so that those addresses will be used for fetching that data and program into the CPU register so that execution of those program code is possible. So for getting the address, we need to know the physical address. For knowing the physical address, we should calculate the physical address. For calculating the physical address, we should know the segment address and the offset address. What is the size of the segment address and the offset address? The size of the segment address and the offset address is 16 bits. What is the size of the physical address? The size of the physical address is 20 bits. As you can see, this segment address in hexadecimal is 1005. Its binary is mentioned here, 1005. Similarly, this offset address is in hexadecimal is 5555H. So now this is the offset address 55555H. Now what we have done is to this segment address, we have shifted by 4 bits. See what we have done, shifted by 4 bits means at the end we have added 4 bits. So we got the 16-bit segment address converted into 20-bit segment address, To this, we are adding the offset. Now, once we got the shifted segment address and the offset address, we are adding both of them. Once we add them, whatever we get is a physical address. And what is the size of this physical address? The size of this physical address is 20 bits. That's how you are going to calculate the physical address. You can see here, the same thing is mentioned here, how to calculate the physical address. Physical address is 20 bits. And this example is a simpler example, and which is self-explanatory also for calculation of the physical address. By the way, we are speaking about the flag registers. So, what is the purpose of the flag registers? The flag registers, as mentioned here, they will be storing the results of calculations of the ALU. What happens in ALU? Computations happens in ALU. Which computations happen in ALU? Arithmetic logic computations happen in ALU. So, what will be the flag register basically doing? The flag registers will be giving the results of the computation, but they also give some flag bits. They also give some flag bit to control the CPU operations, to control the CPU operations. Let us first look at this 8086 architecture. Let us first look at this 8086 architecture. As you can see this diagram, your 8086, look at this diagram for a few seconds. Take few seconds to look at this diagram. Okay, if you are looking at it, are you there with me? Yeah, hopefully you are there with me, and hopefully this diagram also is visible. Let us go slow now. 8086 architecture. This is the diagram for understanding the 8086 architecture. As you can see, this is divided into two parts. The 8086 architecture, at least in this diagram, you see the upper part and the lower part. The upper part has what purpose? The upper part is bus interface unit. The upper part is bus interface unit. What is the lower part? The lower part is execution unit. The lower part is execution unit. Okay. Now, as the name itself indicates, bus interface unit. What the bus interface unit will be doing? The bus interface unit will act as an interface with the peripheral devices. With the peripheral devices, okay? With the help of how it will create the interface? With the help of the buses. With the help of the buses. So basically, if you have few peripheral devices, if you have few external devices, those peripheral devices, those external devices can communicate with the CPU through this bus interface unit, through this bus interface unit. Okay. Now, you also see there is an adder. This adder is used for what purpose? This adder is used for address conversion. This adder is used for address conversion. What address conversion? We just said that we have to compute the physical address. For computing the physical address, what we need? We need the segment address and the offset address. So all that conversion will be done by this adder. This adder is available at which place? This adder is available in the bus interface unit. This adder is available in the bus interface unit. Similarly, what else is there? Similarly, what else is there is something called as instruction byte queue. There is something called as instruction byte queue. This instruction byte queue is available where? This instruction byte queue also is available at the bus interface unit. This instruction byte queue is available at the bus interface unit. Okay. So, what is the purpose of this instruction byte queue? The purpose of this instruction byte queue basically is whenever the CPU or this execution unit is busy with decoding the circuitry with the help of timing and control signals, executing the instruction, parallelly, the bus interface unit can bring another instructions and they can keep them in the queue. They can keep them in the queue and there pre-coding is possible. So this, whatever I just said now, is called as pipelining. So you can see the syllabus content here, and there is a word called as concept of pipelining. We are mentioning the same about that. Okay. So it means what? There is an overlapping. Of what? Fetching the instruction, executing the instruction. Now, I have used two words, fetching the instruction, executing the instruction. Who fetches the instruction? The bus interface unit fetches the instruction. Who executes the instruction? The execution unit executes the instruction. So, this can happen. There can be overlapping of that. Overlapping of that means at the same time, both the activities may be happening. What activities at the same time may be happening? Fetching and execution. So this activity is called as pipelining. So for that only, this instruction byte queue, whose size is 6 byte, so it will be bringing the instructions. Okay. And what is the sequence? The sequence is first in, first out. Okay. So basically, we have understood this architecture of 8086 as you have two major components. One is the bus interface unit. The other one is the execution unit. Now, as you can see in the execution unit, what is there? You have this general purpose registers. You have this index registers. All the register bank is there. But except what? Except the code segment, data segment, extra segment, all the segment register and instruction pointer are where? They are in the bus instruction unit. It means what? What is the purpose of this segment registers and this instruction pointer? This is for addressing. It means address decoding is the objective of bus interface unit. Bus interface unit will be doing the address addressing issue resolution. Now, while the execution unit has arithmetic logic unit, where the actual calculations will be done. It has flags, where the results of the calculations are shown. It has decoding circuitry, where whatever instructions are brought, they'll be decoded. It has these registers, general purpose registers, whose purposes we have already mentioned. So, I think we will stop here, and by this week end, we'll be finishing our module 4, and in the next week we have to fasten a bit, and we may have to take one or two extra lectures to finish the 5th unit. Parallelly, I'll be giving you all that as question bank assignment for unit 4 and unit 5, as well as quiz test for unit 4 and unit 5. So this is the end of the